Hey guys, my name's Rainday and welcome back to How to Play. If you're not familiar with this video series, don't worry. It's where we go in depth on your favorite champions in the realm and teach you some tricks on how to succeed. From basic strategies to advanced tips and also some of those secrets that you may not know about how they play. Either way, we'll help to get you some more wins when you head out into your next match. Today, I thought it'd be best to start out with the Bo brother himself, Shaolin. Ready?
First off, let's take a look at Shaolin's strengths. There's something about a bow that gives a guy swagger. Whether you grew up reading of Richard Rawl in one of my favorite fantasy series, or watching Legolas fight orcs on the big screen, a bow and arrow remains the perfect weapon for smooth, charming, and rather even-tempered champions to fight against evil. Shaolin brings a layer of confidence that borders on cockiness into his persona, but it works for him. The Desert Wind can hold his own in nearly any situation, and that flexibility makes him a great champion to play in nearly any team composition. He can chip away at the enemy team from afar and contest airborne targets well enough to make even the mightiest Drogos player wary to take to the open skies. Yet when things get up close and personal, Shaolin has tools to box out with the best of them. His flexibility is what makes him an excellent all-around damage champion that can be highly prioritized as your main carry or selected to round out your composition with range, poke, and secure those precious last hits. Another strength is that Shaolin doesn't just impact the game from afar, he changes it. With a knockback slash stun as well as high-level bursts and extended periods of stealth, Shaolin adds an element of unpredictability to your composition. Enemies never know when they'll be surprised with a burst of damage, impaled into a wall, and immediately deleted. He can also seem like easy prey, yet disappear the moment you spring to land the finishing blow. Simply buying time can be an asset stealth champions can provide, and Shaolin does it with ease. Now let's move on to the abilities section. Now where should we begin? Maybe with the huge bow and arrow. Shaolin's first skill is called Longbow. His bow draws back significantly powerful arrows that deal up to 1,000 damage each at full draw. The longer you draw your bow, the more damage it does, and vice versa. Be careful of trying to finish off low health targets by quickly tapping your weapon fire, though. They tend to be more like floppy noodles than dangerous, life-ending instruments core to the hunting culture. If you are a fan of firing faster, Shaolin's recurve legendary provides a nice 15% boost to the DPS of his weapon and gives him a safe and guaranteed effect in battle. Shaolin's second skill is called Impaler Arrow. This is a toggleable skill that allows you to replace a normal arrow with a special arrow that will knock back enemies. The best part is that if you happen to knock an enemy back into a wall, it will stun them for 1 second, leaving them helpless to react. Impaling enemies is core to being a good Shaolin player, and this skill is as tantamount to a pocket aces as you'll get in Paladins. This skill is great for turning fights around, gives you tremendous 1v1 potential, and allows you to control the pace of a fight quite well, even from range. The cooldown on this ability only starts when an Impaler Arrow is fired, so feel free to toggle it on and off until you find the right moment to let it loose. Now I've come across some Desert Winds, but I've never felt one that hurt this bad. Planted is Shaolin's moneymaker, game changer, knockout punch, and has always been, in my humble opinion, one of the best damage abilities in Paladins. Shaolin goes to one knee and proposes about 4,800 damage in your face. Yeah, not how I imagine getting proposed to either. He shoots a total of 6 shots, 800 damage each over the course of 3 seconds. It has a small pre-fire delay of 0.6 seconds, which allows a bit of wiggle room for opponents who haven't already been impaled into a wall. If he gets a stun off on you first though, you just gotta sit there and take it. The ability has reduced accuracy while fired in the air, but can be started at any point, even while jumping. A lot of pros do this hop thing. What's the hop thing, guys? Why the hop thing? If you wanna hop, play hopscotch, jump rope, basketball, seriously. If you ever hear this ability sound cue, ready, say no, and run around a corner, seriously. Shaolin's legendary Shifting Sands gives this ability even scarier finishing potential, as he can reset the cooldown on planted, 18 seconds at base, by landing a finishing blow. Taking 18 seconds off of a cooldown is an insane amount of value, but it isn't quite as guaranteed as the other legendary selections. High reward, high risk, I suppose. You be the judge of whether it's a good call. Shaolin's fourth ability, Withdraw, gives a whole new meaning to the idea of an invisible best friend. By the way, invisible best friends are real. You just can't see them. That's why you think they might not be. Am I the only one who understands this? Using this skill makes Shaolin jump back from where he is facing and go invisible, leaving a mirage of himself for 3.5 seconds. Shaolin will stay invisible for 2 seconds unless he takes enough damage or uses an ability before those 2 seconds are up. This ability is already really useful for surprising enemies, running away from tight situations or unfavorable matchups, and buying time for your teammates by stalling out objective fights. However, when using the Desert Shadow Legendary, Shaolin can stay in stealth for up to 5 seconds, while gaining 30% bonus damage on his first shot from stealth. The shot has to happen while he's in stealth, which, for an enemy, almost makes it worse, as they'll never be able to see it coming. Shaolin can use the extra time in stealth to further reposition and find the right moment to strike, while also occasionally deciding to retreat to live and fight another day. This legendary is a bit of a different playstyle choice, as it does put a lot of focus on surprising enemies, staying in the shadows, and landing quick impale stuns into planets for maximum damage. But the upside is it's extremely effective and adds a lot of versatility to his options in a match. Shaolin, when going into his ultimate Heat Haze, can absolutely demolish an enemy team, turning a lost team fight into a guaranteed victory. When he activates Heat Haze, he enters stealth, again, yes, and gains 30% movement speed for 8 seconds. He fires his arrows 50% faster during those 8 seconds, and every time he fires, he leaves a mirage that lasts for 2 seconds on the battlefield, confusing everyone around him more than the creative choices by the director of the Death Note remake on Netflix. Really, what were you doing? This ability can be chained with an extended withdraw stealth to create about 13 seconds of fight time that Shaolin is in stealth. That's a lot of damage coming from the shadows. Last tip about this, don't be afraid to use it to gain momentum, or keep momentum going. Hearing Heat Haze activate will make enemies pause slightly as to what their next move will be. Since Shaolin charges his ultimate very quickly, I advise using it as often as possible to gain even the slightest advantage. Now that we've covered his abilities, let's move on into the loadout. This is the loadout I enjoy the most with Shaolin. It's stable and provides some standard base movement speed and health increases that help him to stay more agile and survive some stickier situations. Grounded is a specific card in this deck that's more personal preference than guaranteed best. I've always valued the 1v1 nature of Planted, and I like the extra healing during the ability to go toe-to-toe with the toughest of opponents. The rest of these cards are easily swappable with things like extra cooldown reduction on eliminations, decreased cooldown on withdraw, or even damage reduction while in stealth or in Planted. Loadouts are highly specific to playstyle and comfortability, so make sure you don't just copy a pro's loadout, but test it, try it, and use something that helps you when you end up playing. For items, Shaolin is incredibly good with the offensive choices. Since he hits for a base of 1,000, he scales extremely well with Wrecker and Bulldozer. Cauterize is a fine pick at all times since he is often looking to burst down and finish targets during the fight. Utility cards also have a good amount of value for Shaolin. He's got relatively higher cooldowns with Planted being at 18 seconds, so Chronos isn't a bad idea. Morale Boost helps him to charge his already fast charging ultimate, and Nimble can be good if you need some extra mobility on the battlefield. Now that we've covered his items, let's move into the tips and tricks. The first tip of the day for Shaolin is withdraw into Planted for an easy kill confirm. Patience and positioning will help you tremendously when playing Shaolin, as the first step can often lead you into an even easier finishing blow. Landing an impale arrow from withdraw using the Desert Shadow Legendary makes for 1300 damage right off the bat. Immediately entering Planted onto the stun target means you can guarantee at least 2100 damage onto an enemy, enough to take down much of the flank damage class by itself. Learning this combo means you can easily get rid of a valuable asset to the enemy team, all from the safety of self. The second your opponent sees you, it should already be too late. Second tip for Shaolin is planting for growth. You don't plant a tree into solid concrete, you try to find fertile soil. The same principle applies here. Many new players simply use Planted whenever, wherever. Heck, sometimes they start fights with Planted just because. When and where Planted is used is important. Bringing down shields, bursting a tank, or finishing slash ending a 1v1 is key to finding value from one of the single most damaging abilities in the entire game. Finding the right moment to use Planted requires keeping vigilant about your position, your teammates, your enemies, the abilities used, and the abilities, hear this, not used, and hopefully having a contingency plan on if things go wrong. Last but not least, range is your friend. Remember, range is your friend. That's right, I said it twice because it's that important. Enemies will try to reduce the range between you and them because you have an advantage the farther away you are most of the time. Careful not to give up that positioning unless it's for a really good reason, as your role is to provide long-range damage from the back lines. If you find yourself dying too often, it's probably because you keep getting into situations you shouldn't be in.
Well, that's going to do it for this episode of How to Play. If you guys enjoyed it, leave a like and let me know in the comment section below if there's anything I might have missed on how to be a pro Shaolin. Also, if you want to check out more of my content, you can check out Rain Day Gaming. The link will be in the description below. You can follow me over there. And of course, keep it locked here for this series in particular on our Paladins Game channel. So make sure to subscribe right now. That'll do it for me, guys. And as always, remember to never give up, never stop gaming. And we'll see you all in the realm.